Winston Churchill usually wrote for money. It was his many books and newspaper articles that underpinned and financed his political career. Yet there is one piece, one essay, which he wrote and very deliberately decided not to publish during his lifetime, and which was only published after his death. It's an essay called The Dream. It's a very humorous piece, but it is also an intensely personal one. In it, Churchill describes how, in November 1947, he is sitting in his painting studio at Chartwell, retouching a damaged portrait of his father, Lord Randolph Churchill. And such is his concentration on this portrait that he summons up an apparition of his father, sitting there in front of him as if he was in his prime, as he was in 1886. I think this is a very revealing piece. It tells you a lot about Churchill's very complex relationship with his father. During Winston's youth, Lord Randolph was a distant and at times very critical figure, and his early death in 1895, aged just 45, left Churchill struggling to prove himself to his father's ghost. And I think that's what this essay is about, because in The Dream, Churchill has to talk Lord Randolph through the events of the last half century, the 50 years since Lord Randolph's death, with its two hugely destructive world wars in which millions of people have died. But what's interesting is that just before Churchill has had the chance to explain his own role in these events, the father's ghost disappears in a puff of cigarette smoke. And as he does, he says these words. "As I listen to you unfolding these fearful facts, you seem to know a great deal about them. I never expected that you would develop so far and so fully. Of course, you're too old now to think about such things. But when I hear you talk, I really wonder you didn't go into politics. You might have done a lot to help. You might even have made a name for yourself."